Of art in industry for all nations, but mostly Britain, and of course, the Empire! With over 100,000 exhibits on display and over 15,000 exhibitors, it is going to be truly a glorious, glorious event. For all those businesses out there that have a jet signed up, stands are still currently available should you wish to exhibit. Maybe you've invented a machine that cleans the dishes. Or you just want to show us some shiny metal things. Everyone is, of course, welcome. Terms and conditions may apply. Stamp prices are very always read the back stuff. The small print. And if that wasn't enough, I can finally confirm that the
Read all about it. Lord Mayor confirms that the world famous The Three Sombreros will be opening the Great British Show. But hurry, as tickets are expected to sell out before they go on sale. Read all about it.
Yes, I can confirm that the one and only Three Sombreros will be performing at the opening show. Yes, you heard right. But not only are the Three Sombreros performing, we are also holding a competition.
What's the competition?
Ah, glad you asked. It's a,
Read all about it. Lord Mayor announces cake competition. The best cake wins free entry to the exhibition, a meet and greet with the Three Sombreros, and a slap up meal for one at Mrs. Miggins' pie shop. Read all about it.
How do they do that?
What can we say? We're good at our job.
Quite, yes, good luck, oven ready, happy baking, and I shall look forward to seeing you all at the show.
Did you hear that?
The Three Sombreros.
I know, right, like OMG, they're my favourite group.
Like, totally. I just can't believe that they're coming to town and I've got the chance to meet them.
I don't know why you lot are getting so excited. You all know that I'm going to win that competition.
Yeah, in your dreams you will.
Yes, but I make the best cakes.
If you say so.
Yeah, we don't call you Soggy Bottom for nothing.
I've never been so insulted.
Yes, you have. We've just never said it loud enough for you to hear.
Ooh. Oh, cheeky!
Right, you lot. Off you go. I'll be having you for breaching the peace.
Sorry, officer.
And you lot, nothing here to see. Move along.
Well, I think that went rather well, Inspector. Everyone seems very excited about the show.
Yes, sir, it would seem so.
I can't tell you what a logistical nightmare it has been. Organising this event, I tell you it has taken years, years to arrange.
A nightmare, sir.
And building the venue, marketing, advertising, and getting genuine businesses to hire stamps. I mean, we have secured the brightest and the best. But there's always the odd one that doesn't make the cut.
There's always one, sir.
Yes, but I must say, I am very excited. And we have done some preliminary figures, and we estimate what with 6 million people coming through over the 6 months, that the show runs, and with the lowest ticket price of 1 shilling, we should make a pretty revenue. And what with everyone paying cash, we should be knee deep in money within the first week.
Potentially a lot of money on site, sir.
Ah, indeed it is, Inspector, indeed it is. Which brings me to my last point. How are the security details coming along?
Well, sir, we have set up a special desk for lost children and umbrellas.
Jolly good. That's pretty much everything sorted then.
Yes, sir.
And I hate to play devil's advocate at this late stage, but we do potentially have a lot of people on site and therefore a lot of money. Have we got anything in place just in case there is some sort of trouble? A task force, perhaps? The army!
No task force, sir, no. Just me and my men.
Ah, excellent. And how many fine men do you have at your disposal?
More than enough, sir. Nothing for you to worry about.
More than 1,000, I should think.
I can't rightly recall, sir.
Fine. I mean, a ballpark figure then. Roughly how many men do you?
Honestly, sir, you don't need to worry.
Inspector! I don't know, how many men?
Very well, sir. There is myself.
Yes.
And.
And?
Sergeant Stopper?
Yes.
That's it. Just the two of you. Why is there only two of you? Availability, sir. Nobody else auditioned.
Unbelievable.
Sign of the times, I'm afraid, sir.
Well, let's just hope and pray nothing untoward takes place, shall we?
No, well, we're not expecting any problems, and like I said, we have set up a special desk for lost children and umbrellas.
Yes, no, I'm sure you're right. That will be more than adequate. Sure. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? It's just a show.
Confused looks on your faces. How did you know, or how did I know that you would be here, despite my never having met you before? Well, let me enlighten you. I know everything. It should be Dave. You sound like a Dave. Yes, you'll soon see what I have planned for the great British show. But I can't stand here talking to you lot. I have things to do. But before I go, there is just one thing. Come closer. Huh? Yes, far enough. I don't want to catch anything from you lot. Now listen very carefully, because I really am going to say this only once. I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you're looking for a good time, I can tell you, you won't find that here. It's pretty much just running around, people shouting and singing, that's all. So you won't find anything here. What I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I have acquired over a long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you. If you leave now, that will be the end of it. I will not look for you. I will not pursue you. But if you don't, I will look for you. I will find you. And I will ignore you. I guess you never thought that
that you would hear this song. Well, I've all bad news for you, 'cause it's really quite long. In use to trouble I anticipate it, so I don't care if you hate it. It's up to you. So what happens now?
Another verse is what he's going to do.
So what happens now?
Another verse is what he's going to do.
Where am I going?
You'll never hear what he has before.
Where am I going to? Time and time again I said that I don't care, that I'm immune to gloom, that I'm hard through and through. I won't recall your names or faces on this one occasion, and that's a consolation for me now. So what happens now?
You won't tell us what he's going to do.
So what happens now?
You won't tell.
Where am I going to?
I'll tell you where I'm going. I'm going off stage right.
Dear Doctor, it's always news.
That's not what I meant, Holmes, and you know it.
Indeed I do. Now, where was I?
Ah, yes. Your very first article, Doctor. So it's in there then, is it?
Mm-hmm. And I must inquire, John, what is the thinking behind this column?
Well, it's an interesting concept, you see. People write into the paper with their medical issues and I give them the answer that is read by many people, and so thus dispensing valuable knowledge to the masses and the individual in question.
I see, makes sense. Which brings me to my next question. What was the particular medical problem that this woman was suffering from that she contacted you about? As, although I'm not a qualified doctor, you understand, I haven't been particularly well-versed in all manner of medicine. I can't help but wonder what terrible malaise this is. I've got no eggs for my muffins. What shall I do?
That's not a medical question, Holmes, and you know it.
Well, I'm relieved to hear it, as I myself thought I might have a case of cheesy crumpets developing as we speak.
Well, obviously it's going to take a while to catch on, but in the interim, I'm going to carry on answering the questions with the same outcome. You know, dispensing valuable knowledge to the masses and the individual in question, and just helping people.
Admirable. And were you able to assist this particular reader?
I think so. She was asking me what she could substitute eggs for, because she's been unable to buy any in the shortage. So I told her she could use one tablespoon
of vegetable oil mixed with 1 tablespoon of water and 1 teaspoon of baking powder per egg. Ah, yes, the egg shortage brought about by the chicken strike.
I could hardly believe that the chickens would strike.
Indeed, but the NUC.
NUC?
National Union of Chickens. Yes, union bosses said that their members were clucking mad. Striking due to poor working conditions and paltry wages.
But I thought the strike was over and the chickens had gone back to work.
It is, and they have, although they've settled far too quickly, if you ask me. I mean, the wage increase they've negotiated is simply chicken feed. Ah, interesting.
You think that's interesting? I had a patient recently who met a duck that he wanted to marry.
I assume you told him he was absolutely quackers?
It's not a laughing matter, Holmes. The gentleman obviously had some serious medical issues.
Absolutely, and I am taking it most seriously. As after all, marriage isn't all it's quacked up to be.
Holmes!
Yes, okay, I'm sorry. No more. No more, I promise.
Thank you.
Is it a bit warm in here, is it me?
Yes, the weather is particularly clement at present. Do you want me to open a window?
Yes, if you wouldn't mind.
How much?
Just a quack. Do you smell that?
Don't look at me.
No, Doctor, it's coming from outside.
What is?
Faint hint of sulphur, if I'm not mistaken.
I can't smell anything.
Mrs. H, someone's at the door.
Coming! How is Miss Hudson?
Oh, admirably well, considering.
Oh! Good morning, Doctor. What's up? I didn't know you were here. Good morning, Miss Hudson. Lovely to see you. How are you keeping?
Oh, you know me, I can't complain. But if you do get a walk, could you take a look at my bunions? They are playing me up something terrible. Oh, and then there's a sciatica in my back. That's bad too.
I'm sorry to hear that.
It's because of her knockers.
I'm sorry.
It's my own fault. Mr. Holmes said it would happen. Mind you, they do look good. You're welcome to look at them if you like, Mr. Wilson, but I'd be appreciative if you didn't touch them.
Well, perhaps I should explain. As you know, Mrs. H is particularly house-proud.
What respectable housekeeper isn't?
Absolutely, and her sciatica has been playing up because she's been going around the house over-polishing everything, including the brass knockers on the front door.
As my dear old mother used to say, have pride in your knockers. Because they're the first thing people see when they come round. So make sure they're clean and ready to be grabbed.
Very true. Wise words indeed.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt this little exchange, but there is a small matter at the door, Mrs. H.
I'll get right on it. I wish people wouldn't grab them so hard. They're going to come right off in someone's hand one day. Come in! Oh, hello there. Come in if you'll just wait here. Inspector Bung to see you, sir.
Ah, very good. Send him in.
Mr. Inspector.
Inspector. To what do we owe this visit?
Well, sorry to bother you, Mr. Holmes, but as you're probably aware, the Great British Show opens next week.
Yes, and?
Well, the mayor thinks it might be a good idea.
Thinks it would be a good idea if we made some inquiries to see if there is any trouble brewing ahead of the grand opening.
Well, yes, but...
What with there being only two of you to police the entire event, but you've got a special desk for lost children and umbrellas.
How do you...
Know these things? Elementary, my dear Inspector. I can tell by your tired expression, blisters that you're suffering from. Two on your left big toe, one on your right. Yes, I noticed your unusual gait as you entered the room. The slight stooping of your shoulders says to me that you've been on duty for more hours than you should. Coupled with the fact that during dress rehearsal I spotted only two police uniforms. As for the desk, well, children and umbrellas get lost at an alarming rate in the city. Especially on family days out. My deductions were simply a case of putting two and two together and making, well, an omelette.
What?
Trust me, Inspector. You don't want to know how he does it.
Needless to say, Dr. Watson and I will be delighted to offer our assistance.
Oh, that's very good of you, Mr. Holmes, but I'm not really expecting any problems.
No, of course you're not.
I see a problem arising. I see trouble on the way. I see drinking and the fighting.
Stick 'em up!
I see bad times today.
Let's go out tonight. There's bound to be a sight. There's a problem on the rise.
Hope you have got your things together. Hope you are quite prepared to die. Looks like we're in for nasty weather. One night is taken for a night.
Let's go out tonight. There's bound to be a sight. There's a problem on the rise. There's a problem on the rise.
Some tea. Mrs. H!
Oh, come in, come in.
Here you go.
Lovely, thank you, Mrs. Hudson. The tea, oh, it looks delicious.
Are you quite welcome? I'm just sorry there's no cakes.
I've got no eggs. Oh, I thought you placed an order with the milkman yesterday.
Ah, you did, but when I went to the doorstep this morning, there was only milk.
Oh, well, you can always use the substitute ingredients I told you about.
Oh, Mr. Holmes, I don't know what you take me for. I'm many things, but I'm definitely not a faker.
Only ribbing you, Mrs. H. I know you'd never use substitute ingredients. I really do love your baking.
Oh, Mr. Holmes, you are an awful teasing like that.
Seriously, though, your baking is par excellence.
Ooh.
I often dream about your chocolate eclairs, your Victoria sponge, and as for your big fruity buns. Well, what can I say?
Yum?
Double yum, oh. Yes.
I should be able to make some more soon. I've got to go down to the docks to pick up some eggs today.
Ah, well, Dr. Whatsup and I will look forward to whatever culinary delight you have in store for us.
If you'll excuse me, sir, I must be getting on. I'll see myself out.
Oh! See here, Miss Hudson. There's a cake competition at the Great British Show.
A cake competition? Nah, not for me, thanks. I'm quite happy making cakes for you and Mr. Holmes and your guests.
But the winner gets a free entry to the exhibition.
Hey, what do I want to go to an exhibition for? What can I read about it in a paper?
Oh. There's also a voucher for a slap-up meal for one at Mrs. Miggins' pie shop.
Ooh, Mrs. Miggins' famous steak and kitty pie? Nah, not for me, thanks.
Well, you can't say I didn't try. I mean, you definitely won't be interested in meeting the three sombreros.
What did you say?
What? Did I try?
No! About the three sombreros!
Well, it says here that not only will the three sombreros be opened up the show,
oh,
they'll also be judging the cake competition.
Oh.
And the winner gets the chance to meet them.
Oh, oh my, I've got to go, I've got to go.
Mr. Hudson, you all right?
Yes, I think I've left something on in the oven and, oh my, the three sombreros.
What was that all about?
Never mind all that. I feel it's time you and I went for a walk.
Yes, yes, keep the booze coming. I love the booze.
Yes, well, I see you're still here, despite what I told you. Nothing here for you.
But don't do refunds.
Don't do refunds. No, I wouldn't do a refund either. Don't blame them. But I can tell you this. No one is going to stop my plan from working. Oh. No one. Not even young Dave over there. Or should I say, Aaron Andrew David. You see, I know everything. I told you. You shouldn't doubt me. silly name anyway, Aaron. Aaron. Aaron.
Oh. So, is everything sorted, Inspector?
Yes, sir. The special desk for lost children.
I knew about the special desk. Anything else? Have we heard from Mr. Holmes yet?
Well, not yet, sir. As far as I'm aware, he's only just left the stage.
Let's just hope he doesn't find anything. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
I mean, seriously, what could possibly go wrong?
Oh, nothing, sir. I sent Sergeant Stobber down to the docks to collect the three sombreros as their ship is due in shortly. He's then taking them straight to the hotel, as we really don't want anyone to know they've arrived or where they are. As goodness knows, we couldn't protect them if their fans knew they were already here, sir.
That's very, very, very good. Very good, Inspector. And which hotel did we book them into?
The Savaloy.
Ooh! The Savaloy! Wouldn't have been my first choice, bit of a reputation. But then each to his own. Savaloy.
Afternoon, sir.
Bonjour.
A foreign visitor to our sunny shores, Inspector. I wonder if he's legal. No, he's all right for a week. I wonder if he knows about the ship.
Hello.
Hello to you too. A welcome to England. Yeah? No, not the top bit. That's what we did. Independent. I hope you enjoy your stay. You must visit the show. It starts on Monday. Great British Show. Inspector, some help here, please. Explain the Great British Show. Four words.
Show.
First word. Do you want this game? Great. Great, sir.
Great,
sir. Great. Sounds like eight.
Oh.
Or eight.
Eight.
Or I hate you. No. Never was very good at the foreign relations. No. British, sir! British, sir! Stick up a lip, sir! Empire!
Tea.
Tea, sir. Cup of tea.
Tea.
Cricket, sir! Cricket. Four, sir. Through the covers. The Great British Show! Start
somebody.
Help me.
I remembered it tonight, sir.
Yeah. Marvellous. There you go, sir. Show.
Ah, wee wee!
I'm sure there are some local facilities in the vicinity, but I maybe will get the inspector to help on this one.
No,
Inspector, I am not miming this one out.
No.
Inspector, you'll be so kind. Please excuse me. I have negotiations to sort out.
Yes.
What was that?
Oh, yes, sir, I'll be right there. Sorry about this, sir. Coming! Have a good day, sir.
Oh, yes, I will. So, them drafted in Sherlock Holmes, have they? Well, makes no difference. Nothing and no one is going to stop my plan from working. they won't know what hit them. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have things to do and people to see.
Excuse me, my head's all up in the clouds at the moment. Are you all here to see the Great British Show as well, then?
Yeah.
Are you all here to see the Great British Show as well, then?
Yeah.
Oh, jolly good. Wasn't really interested myself, you know. And then, oh, my favourite band, the Three Sombreros, are performing. Oh, and they're judging the competition, and I might get a chance to meet them. Oh, so I just had to go. I've got to win that competition, but just got no eggs. Fortunately for me, I've got an auntie in America whose partner is big in chickens. That doesn't sound right. You know what I mean. Anyway, so she's sending some over. Now, I was a bit worried they'd go off, but she said, "Ah, it's all right, I'll send them express." I knew you wouldn't get that, never mind. Anyway, I must get on, I've got things to do. Oh. Right, there's my little note.
See, it is most upsetting that there is nobody here to beat us.
Okay?
Let us ask the senora. Maybe she is here to beat us.
Good idea.
Es always una mujer?
See, that's a woman.
No. Es imposible.
Excuse me, senora. Are you here to beat us?
I beg your pardon?
My friend wants to know if you are here to beat us.
What?
Beat us on the body.
You're asking me if I'm here to beat you on the body? No, I'm not here to greet you, but perhaps I can help you out. Where are you from and who are you? Where are you going?
I am Manuel.
Oh.
Carlos.
Okay. You need tissue or?
And then Andes!
That's a long time.
And I am Miguel Pablo Rodriguez.
Phil.
Si, Phil.
Just Phil?
Si, just Phil.
Oh, that's better.
Alfonso Juan, Ignacio Diego Luis, Alejandro Javier Mario, Enrique Constantine Sebastian, Frederique Carlito, Lopez!
You know, that's quite funny actually, your names, Manuel Carlos Fernandez, Miguel Pablo Rodriguez, and Phil. No, I don't have to do it, no. Felipe Alfonso Juan Ignacio Diego Luis Alejandro Javier Mario Enrique Constantin Frederique Sebastian Carlito Lopez. They're exactly the same names as my favourite group, the Three Sombreros.
Si.
So if you're Manuel Carlos Fernandez and you're Miguel Pablo Rodriguez and you're Phil. No, not again. Felipe Alfonso Juan Ignacio Diego Luis Alejandro Javier Mario Anika Costi Federico Sabisi Sebastian Lopez. And it looks like you've got some bags and
You've got a picture of you, an upside down picture of you just as the three sombreros. Ah, I get it, I know what you are. You're a tribute act.
No!
There's no such thing as a tribute act yet, is there? You must be imposters!
No!
Well, then that must mean you are the three sombreros!
See? Si.
I don't believe you. Prove it! Oh, they're gonna prove it, all right. Here we go. See what you got.
Around. Especially little urchins called Aaron. If you'd like to follow me, I'll take you to where you'll be staying permanently. Hi, Miss
Gracias.
If you'd like to follow me this way.
Gracias, sir. Señora.
Oh, no need to worry about her. I'll look after you first and I'll come back and help her, all right? Yes, this way, this way, here we go. There you go. Good, good, good. I mean, it's not like somebody's going to try and steal her now, is it?
Evening, all! Hello, hello, hello! What sort of crowd's this then?
Blimey, we got a few rough ones in here tonight, haven't we? I've seen you before, your picture's down the station, isn't it? I don't know what this village is coming to. Whatever would PC Porter have to say? Well, there's a name that sends a shiver up a few spines. Didn't know it was Vickers and Tarts. Didn't anybody tell you it's the blokes that are supposed to dress up as the Vickers? I don't know. You're telling me you're a real Vicar, Ned. Hello? Excuse me, miss, you can't take a nap here. Come on, let's have you on your way. Miss, are you all right?
Oh, I'm going! Oh, my very own sombrero! It's like all my Christmases have come at once. Oh, don't struggle, my darling.
darling! Oh, man! Who are you? Help me up!
Are you all right, miss? Have you lost something?
All in my dignity.
Sorry?
No. I was on my way to the docks when I ran into the three sombreros and it was just so... So...
Oh, I see, and... these sombreros, then. You didn't... let me see now. Let me see. I'll think of this line in a second. We'll jump to the next one.
They didn't lock me out. I was having to lay down, that's all.
And, right then. We'll try this one. Okay, You didn't happen to see where these sombreros went, did you?
No, I'm afraid not, but I did hear him talking to someone, though.
Any idea who?
I'm afraid not, no. Now you have to excuse me, I've got to get to the docks, I've got to get me eggs. Ooh!
Blimey, this is a mystery then, isn't it? What am I going to do now? I don't suppose any of you lot saw what went on, did you?
Yes.
Oh, well, that sounds like a big help. This person who talked to the sombreros, like, was it a man? Was it a woman?
A man.
We're getting somewhere now. This man, was he pretending to be somebody else?
Yes!
Like?
Pretending French.
Not like a policeman. A policeman, you say? Did he have a policeman's uniform like this?
No.
Policeman's hat, maybe? What did he have?
A badge.
A badge, cool. Thank you very much. Right, so we've got this man, he's got a policeman's badge, and he's taking the sombreros off somewhere?
Yes.
This sounds serious. I'd better let the inspector know. Who put that sign there? Better move this one out of the way.
Are you sure it's safe to be in this part of town at this time of night, Holmes? I mean,
there certainly are some undesirables. It's never safe around here, but needs must. Look, just keep your valuables hidden and don't make eye contact.
But why are we here? To get some information, of course. What sort of information could we get from a place like this? Look, for someone so intelligent, you are incredibly stupid sometimes. Look, excuse me, sir, but where does one go when they need to know what's going on in the world?
Pub.
You see, this man, we've done this about three times now. The first one said pub. You see? Come on, doctor. But where are we actually going? Oh, come on, doctor, you'll see.
Okay, what'll it be?
Four pies, please. I meant four pies.
Four pies, is it?
Yeah.
And, how old would we be exactly?
32.
32? Seriously?
24.
Okay. So you're all 18 years old, are you?
Yeah.
And I'm the Queen of Sheba.
Pleased to meet you, Your Majesty.
Oi, drink over here, Peggy.
You could have just said the pub. Could have, should have, but didn't.
Where else are we going to get the kind of information we're looking for?
It's a bit rough in here.
Oh, it's perfect. Now, you get us a seat and I'll go and chat to the landlord over there. Chap there.
And who is he?
Loose Lips Larry. Ambriff, for information, he's our man.
With a name like that, he's got to be.
Just relax. Remember, these are your people.
And I said no.
As the beer's always wet.
Why didn't you say so? Any friend of theirs is a friend of mine.
Oh, lovely.
Who are they?
Well, a couple of brothers that help keep out of jail. It always helps out a couple of scallywags on the outside. They told me about this place, the Drunken Dog. Said if we ever needed to know what was really going on, this is the place to come. Now, follow my lead. Remember, we don't want to alert anyone as to who we really are.
Why? Because that would be bad. How bad?
You don't want to know.
Drink?
Thought you'd never ask. Three more pints over here for me and my mates. Cheers?
Cheers!
Cheers!
I can only stay for a couple as I promised the old lady I'd get some eggs so she can enter that cake thing for the fancy show thing.
You'll be lucky.
Bill! And this here is Ted, the mate from work.
I'm sick and tired of hearing about this great bleeding British show. It's all anyone goes on about. This geezer came in here for a drink the other week and all he did was go on about how he'd invented the next big thing and how he was going to be appearing at the Great British Show. But no, he got refused. And so he said...
There and then, the nerve.
Some people.
Well or never.
Apparently, he's got a plan or something. We was drinking hard and it got pretty messy.
I'll bet. Is he a regular then?
Nah. But he's been in here a few times. According to my mate, Dodgy Pete, He's seen him going into an old abandoned warehouse just a few streets from here.
Did I hear my name?
All right, Pete. I was just telling Bill and Ted, yeah, about that geezer from the other week.
Geezer? Which one? Ooh, Slippery Sid.
No, not Slippery Sid.
Do you mean Dirty Dave?
No, not Dirty Dave. The one that went on about the Great British Show.
Oh, yeah, right. That bloke, yeah.
Do you know him then?
Know him? No. But I said to Larry here, there is definitely something strange going on with him. And that warehouse I've seen him going into.
Strange? How?
Well, just comings and goings at all hours of the day and night. All the doors and windows are barred. It's just strange, you know? I've got a sixth sense about these things.
I see.
No. I see.
Looks like Ted is done for the night. Are you sure he knows John and Jim? It's not like them to hang out with such a lightweight.
Of course, it's just that we started drinking at lunchtime.
So?
Lunchtime yesterday.
Hardcore. I bet he's single.
Of course.
What he needs is a good woman to keep him on straight and narrow.
Well, he did have a lady earlier on offer to show him her knockers. She said he could look, but she'd rather if he didn't touch.
Sounds like my missus.
Anyway, on that note, I'd better get Ted home before he gets his second wind.
Don't be a stranger, and if you see John and Jim, tell him it's their round.
Doctor, what's up? What's up? Doctor, what's up?
Nothing's up. I just want to go sleepy by.
Come on, Ted, let's get you home.
Ted, but I'm just getting started. I want another drink.
Oh, too late.
Spectacular! No words in the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be dumb with wonderment. Returns are fixed at 10%. You must agree that is excellent. And on top of your fee, you'll be involved up artistically.
So exciting, the audience is not rushing. So delighted, in the rump of 58. So exciting, the audience is not rushing. So delighted, in the rump of 58.
Elephants, Arabians, Indians and courtesans, acrobats and jumping bears, exotic girls, fire eaters, muscle men, contortionists, intrigue, danger and romance, electric, that's machinery, power, electricity.
So exciting, the audience was not pushing. So delighting, in the rump of 58. So exciting, the audience was not pushing. So delighting, in the rump of 58.
Spectacular, no words in the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be done with wonderment.
So exciting, the audience is not pushing. So delighting, in the rump of 58. So exciting, the audience is not pushing. So delighting, in the rump of 58.
Ladies and gentlemen!
Read all about it! Cake competition thrown into chaos as egg shortage continues. Chicken strike over, but no eggs to be found anywhere. Read all about it!
Seriously! I saw. Well, this is not good. This is not good at all. We better let Mr. Holmes know ASAP, and let's keep this between us. We don't want to jeopardise the show now, do we? No.
Read all about it! Breaking news, the three sombreros are missing! Officials fear the worst, that they've changed their minds. Read all about it!
Come on! How do they do that? I give up.
Are the three sombreros really missing?
What's going on?
We demand answers.
Yes, and if you could be quick, because I've got a cake in the oven.
Are you sure it's not a flan?
ladies and gentlemen, I have absolutely no idea where this information is coming from. But I can assure you that the three sombreros are perfectly safe and sound, and are looking forward to opening the show. Isn't that right, Inspector?
Absolutely.
Should I go and let Mr. Holmes know, sir?
Yes, Sergeant, and hurry. There's no time for delay.
Well, what are we to do, Inspector?
Oh, everything will be all right, sir. Don't you worry. We'll find them.
It's just all so upsetting. With only a few days left, it's quite stressful.
I can imagine, sir.
I'm not sleeping, you know.
Oh, really?
And I'm off my food. What? I don't know what to do.
Well, maybe I can find some way to cheer you up, sir. Don't worry, it'll all be all right. Raindrops on roses and whiskers and kittens, bright copper kettles and woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favourite things. Your answer, tell me some of yours.
Cream-coloured ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favourite things.
That's the spirit, sir.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver-white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favourite things. I the mood has most certainly been lightened. However, I have to add that the scenery change behind is quite complicated. And therefore, we probably should sing this song one more time.
Yes.
And if the audience would like to join in, if they know the words, then please do. And of course, if you don't, just make them up like we do. Thank you. Yes.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favourite things. Cream colored ponies and crisp apple strudels,
doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings.
These are a few of my favourite things. Girls in white dresses with pink satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white pincers that melt into springs. These are a few of my favourite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favourite things. And then I don't feel so bad.
I feel positively euphoric.
I'll let go of me this time.
To me, like you was up to some mischief.
Us? What do you mean?
Not us. We as good as gold.
That's right, good as gold.
Good, because I've got enough to worry about today without any nonsense from you lot. Off you go now, go on, off you go. I don't know, there's something funny about them boys and I can't quite put my finger on it.
Do you have to be so loud?
Ah, my friend. The perils of not being able to handle your drink. Hair of the dog, perhaps?
No, thank you.
How about a fright?
Oh, you really are cruel, Holmes.
I'm sorry, Doctor, I do like to tease.
I mean, I can understand why my head hurts, but I can't for the life of me understand why my posterior's hurting.
Yes, well, perhaps now's a bad time to tell you about your tattoo.
Tattoo?
Ah, saved by the knockers. Mrs. H, someone's at the door.
Oh, of all the days it had to be today, is it? Oh, I come up to my eyes in bacon. Oh, don't worry, old Harriet will get it off. Oh, look, what do you want? I come in. It's the sergeant to see you.
Yes, sergeant.
Well, sir, it would appear that someone has kidnapped the three sombreros.
Kidnap the three sombreros? Why? What did you just say?
Calm yourself, Mrs. H. Let the sergeant finish.
when I went down to the docks to meet them, I got there and they'd already gone. Already gone? Yes, sir.
With who?
Apparently, it was with somebody impersonating a police officer.
Oh, well, who else knew they were arriving yesterday?
Well, there was myself, obviously, the inspector, the mayor, and, oh, yes, your housekeeper was there.
Mrs. H?
Well, I was there, but I wasn't there, if you know what I mean.
Not really.
Explain.
And I was on the way to the docks to pick up the eggs, and I ran into the three sombreros.
And?
And I,
I found her flat on her back.
Mrs. Hudson! So that's what you meant yesterday when you got home and said you'd had the best time of your life.
No, it was nothing like that. I just got all dizzy and I had a bit of a lie down. Now, don't tell me neither of you have had a lay down in the street before.
Touché, Mrs. H. You should have seen the doctor last night. Lying down on the job would have been the least of his worries.
Why? What did I do?
Why, don't you remember?
No.
Should I? Probably best not to. Anyway, we'll talk about your drink problem later. Let's get back to the case in hand.
But I don't have a drink problem.
That's what they all say, sir. I've heard it time and time again.
Let's look at what we know, shall we?
Oh, that's my cue to go and make a cup of tea, I think. Let me know when it gets to my sombrero. I mean, the three sombreros, okay?
So, Inspector Bunn called in to see me on Monday morning.
That's right. It was just when the mayor was doing the countdown to the great show. He sent the inspector round here to make sure there was nothing to worry about.
Yes, and prior to the inspector's arrival, the doctor and I were talking about an article in the newspaper.
What? It's official. Death is the nation's number one killer.
No. We were discussing that how the chicken strike was over, but there was still a shortage of eggs.
Oh, yes, I remember. And?
Well, let's look at the facts, shall we? We have this chicken strike, which has got nothing to do with anything, and is now over, yet there is still an egg shortage. Very strange. Plus, there's the fact that the mayor announces, or doesn't, because the paper boys do it before he can, that there is to be a cake competition, the winner of which wins free entry to the show, a meal for one at Mrs. Miggins' pie shop, and the pièce de résistance, the chance to meet the world-famous The Three Sombreros, who are due to sing and judge said cake competition. Are you both with me so far?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Plus, there's the information I gleaned from Loose Lips Larry and Dodgy Pete, which, if I'm not mistaken, refers very much to this case.
Oh, here we go.
How are we getting on? Is he there?
No, I don't think so.
Do you know what? I do think, and this is between you and me now, he does like the sound of his own voice. So, if he could pay people to hear him talk, he would.
Oh, good tea. Yes, very good. Now, where was I?
I'm just going to pop in the shops.
Right, back to the sombreros, who no one knew were arriving, yet they were kidnapped anyway, so obviously someone did know, but who?
Can I take it that you're ruling out your housekeeper as a possible suspect?
Oh, goodness me, of course. Mrs. H wouldn't hurt a fly, let alone kidnap anyone. Actually, did the inspector give you something to give to me?
Oh, yes, sir. I almost forgot.
There you go. Thank you. So, no one knew they were arriving, but kidnapped anyway, and a cake competition that no one could win without eggs.
Ha ha ha! But you said that you could substitute eggs with, was it, one tablespoon?
Yes, but no respectable baker would actually do that. No, a true baker would know you can't win a cake competition without the correct ingredients.
This may not be relevant, Mr. Holmes, but every time the mayor went to make a public address, the paper boys would announce it first before the mayor had a chance to say anything. It was almost like they
knew in advance. Uh-huh.
What is it?
Why, my dear friend,
It confirms one of my suspicions.
Well, aren't you going to tell us?
What, when we've got two scenes left? I hardly think so.
Well, what should we do, Mr. Holmes?
We're going to save the Three Sombreros and get to the show before it opens, as I feel this is where it's all leading us to.
But how are you going to save the Three Sombreros and get to the show on time?
Yes, good point. Yes, we could really do with Mrs. H's assistance with this.
She's gone shopping. She'll be gone for hours.
Did I hear my name?
Good. Mrs. H, would you accompany the sergeant to this address? If what Loose Lips Larry and Dodgy Pete said is true, then I believe you'll find the Three Sombreros there.
Oh, of course, Mr. Holmes. Anything to help.
Excellent. And Doctor, if you would go and see the mayor and tell him not to open the doors. The public must not be let in until I get there. Do you understand? It's imperative that no one get in.
Understood, Holmes, but where are you going to be?
I need to pay a visit.
You should probably do that before you leave the house.
Yes, not what I meant, Mrs. H, but thank you for the concern.
No,
something I must do. And if my suspicions are correct, then it could be the key to solving this whole thing.
Right, does everyone know what they're doing?
Yes!
Yes! Right, see you at the show.
Well, that's the Three Sombreros taken care of. Now just the final few pieces of my plan to put into place, and then the Great British Show will certainly go off with a bang. You're still here, despite what I said. Oh, don't blame it on me later on when you're all clambering to get out. I did warn you. It's not my fault you're all too stupid to leave. You're probably thinking, oh, everything will be all right. Sherlock Holmes will save the day.
Well, I can tell you that will not be happening this time. I will not be messed around with. My plan will succeed. You'll soon see about that. Ah, boo all you like. We'll soon see who's laughing at the end of this. And I can tell you for a fact, it won't be me.
Now that's not right, is it? Now scratch that, forget that. It will be me laughing at you laughing at me. Oh, you know what I mean. I feel good.
Sugar is fine.
Sugar is nice.
I feel nice.
Sugar is nice.
Like sugar is fine.
Sugar is nice.
Like sugar is fine.
Sugar is nice.
Mrs. Hudson. Only you seem a little unsettled.
I am all right. I am just a bit nervous, though.
Well, as long as you're sure, you stay put here and I'll go and have a little look through here. I won't be long.
All right, all right. Are you all right, you lot?
Yes.
Oh, are you going to help me look for the three sombreros?
Yes.
Oh, jolly good. I'm just a bit worried, though, in this old warehouse. There's all kinds of creepy crawlies and all sorts of rats and, all the worst thing, spiders. Oh, I hate them with their long, long legs and their big, hairy bodies. Oh, they just keep me going. Can you see one now? Where is it? Behind me? Oh, there's nothing here. Don't wake me up. Come on, I'm very delicate, lady. Stay by me now. Why are you doing this to me? There's no spider. I don't know where you... Look.
Screaming.
Giant spider!
Giant spider, where? There's nothing here, are you sure you're all right?
Oh. It was there, it was huge!
Well, it's not here now, you must have scared it off.
What are you saying? We ain't got time for that now, we've got to find the three sombreros.
Right, I don't think all that's necessary.
Well, look, drastic times call for drastic measures. Right, you hold on to that.
Mr. Holmes said he didn't think it was likely that anybody would be guarding the sombreros. The criminal just wanted to keep them out of the way while he got on with his dastardly deed.
Right, well, that means there'll be no one waiting for me then, doesn't it?
That's a lot of one way down.
All right, here we go. Just keep hold, Sergeant, right? Just keep hold!
Yeah, I'm right
here. Oh! Too tight. Right, I'm gonna go on the count of three, all right?
Right, I've got you.
One.
Oh.
Two. Three, I'm happy. I'll go down backwards, hear me that.
Right, just keep on.
Oh, I don't like it.
Are
you ready?
Are we ready? Yes, we're ready.
Get up! Oh! Hello! Oh! Oh, I can't see anyone! Manuel! Miguel!
Did you hear that?
No, I didn't hear nothing. Stop it, you give me the willies!
I think it's a bit late for that, Mrs. Hudson. Shall we? I'll go this way.
I'll go this way. Right. Oh, I've got to find these sombreros. They mean the world to me. Your voice is warm and tender.
lives for you.
I said, hope so. Oh, it's been... Oh, oh, Phil! Miguel! Manuel! Oh, oh Manuel! Oh, Manuel!
I think it's time we were going.
Yeah, you're probably right. Let's go, let's go!
Doctor, what did Mr. Holmes say exactly?
He said not open the show until he arrives.
Did he say why?
I'm afraid not, but he said it's imperative you do not let anybody in.
So we've got no sombreros, something might or might not happen, and we have absolutely no idea what is going on. It sounds like Brexit. No, I mean, is that about the strength of it in this current situation?
Yes, that about sums it up.
Oh dear, this is not good. I mean, I've told the inspector not to let anyone in, but I can't put it off indefinitely. We have got exhibitors paying good money and the like to show their inventions to the public. And they are not going to be best pleased if we don't open the doors now. And the public are outside queuing as we speak.
I'm sure he'll be here.
The doors are locked, but some of the exhibitors are threatening to leave if we don't open shortly.
Leave! We've been trying to do that for 3 years. Nobody can leave. What sort of you? What sort of show would we have then? We are going to have to bite the bullet and open the doors soon. Yes.
He will be here. You just have to give him more time.
Time, my dear doctor, is a luxury we can't afford. I just ask the audience members what it's like sitting on those chairs for a long time. The right cheek tends to numb first, man. And may I just say that if you try to instigate some life back into it, make sure you are rubbing your own. I speak from alleged experiences. No. We are going to have to carry on whether we like it or not.
Oh, there you are, Sergeant. How did it go? Did you find them?
Yes, sir. Mrs. Hudson and I secured the release of the three sombreros and brought them straight here.
Where are they?
I thought it best to lock them in their dressing room until they were needed. Keep them out of the way until Mr. Holmes has solved the case.
Very good indeed, Sergeant. So we are just waiting for Mr. Holmes then?
He'll be here soon. You know what he's like. He likes to make a grand entrance.
Indeed he does.
Inspector, why don't you come with me and we'll keep a lookout for him?
Right, where should I put my entry for the cake competition?
Where did you get that?
I've had it on me since we left the house.
What, all this time? Where did you hide it?
Hey, a woman never tells. But I can show you if you like. You see, I've got a secret compartment.
No. Keep it secret, thank you. I don't want to see that.
Thank you.
Oh, if you're sure.
I just put it in the other room on the table with the other entrance.
Other entries?
Hey, we had 275.
275?
Yes.
There's only 25 people in the cast.
You are as short as we are all, Mrs. Hudson. However, I must say I am very excited. Although with the egg shortage, some of the offerings are a little less cakey than we would like, especially the Weetabix cake. For the Charlotte Millards, don't go near it.
Oh dear. I may still be able to chance.
Then. Oh yes!
Okay.
Sorry I took so long, Mr. Mayor. Inspector. Oh. Things to do and all that.
Yes, Mr. Hurd, but can we commence with the show?
Nearly. Are the sombreros secure?
Yes, sir. Locked in the dressing room, as you said.
Ah, good. We don't want our criminal mastermind to know his plans have changed. Ah, Mrs. H, everything okay?
Aye, all good here, Mr. Holmes.
So, what are we going to do?
Why, Inspector, we're going to let the people in.
What? But you said...
I know. You'll just have to trust me. I know what I'm doing. Sergeant, if you'd be so kind.
Oh, for goodness sake, just open the doors!
I think it's about time I did explain what's going on.
Yes.
Sounds about like time for me to go to the gift shop here. Let me know when he gets to the three song. That's the wrong thing.
So? Oh, yes. Do you recall I remarked about that smell?
Ah, yes. Faint hint of sulfur, if I remember rightly.
Correct, and that had puzzled me for most of the show. But I'll tell you why. At every morning, at precisely 8 a.m, the milkman delivers milk and eggs to our doorstep. And yet, at 8:04 a.m, when you open the window, there was that distinct whiff of sulfur coming from outside. Well, if anyone knows anything about eggs, they'll know that that means they've gone off. But they hadn't gone off. No, as Mrs. Hudson will testify. They were gone.
Stolen, perhaps?
Precisely, Sergeant. But by whom? Anybody? No? Well, it had to be someone who had access to the doorstep. And a lot of doorsteps. As remember, the chicken strike was over, but the eggs were still going missing. So, who had access to the doorstep, and why did they need these eggs?
To enter the cake competition.
Ah, possibly. But why so many eggs? And why the bad smell? Then there's the kidnapping. Why would anyone need to take the sombreros out of the equation?
Ransom?
Possibly, but unlikely, as there was no ransom note. And no one knew they had gone, except for the paper boys.
So they were up to something?
No, they didn't do anything, but they did see something.
Ah, what did they see?
They saw a certain someone... stealing eggs.
What?
Yes, I'm afraid they saw everything.
How are we getting on? Is he there? No? I'm going to get myself a cup of tea then. I bet she'd wish she'd bought cushions for those chairs, don't you?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, but I think you do.
But... that doesn't explain how the paper boys knew what was going to happen before it did.
Yes, we'll get to that eventually, but Mrs. A should really be here for the next...
Hey, did I hear my name?
Sergeant, do you remember that file you gave me earlier on?
Yes, sir.
Well, that file contained all of the applications that had been refused to stand at the show.
But there was only one.
Yes. Do you remember who it was for and why?
I don't recall the name. But It was for some ghastly hand cream made out of horse manure, no less. What was it called? Poo!
It wasn't ghastly, it was genius!
Poo?
It's not poo, it's pew! P-U-E! It stands for perfectly unique emollient. Which means it has the capability of softening or smoothing the skin.
I don't care what it stands for. It still... It stinks.
But I blended the manure with some secret ingredients to make the silkiest cream you could ever use. You didn't even try the sample I sent you.
No, I should think not. It smelt... Bad!
But... Feel how soft my hands are! Feel how soft they are! They're lovely and soft!
No wonder why he calls it pew!
Oh. I'm sorry, Hex, but I'm still confused.
Hey, you're not the only one. Look at the audience.
Anyway, as revenge on those who had ruined his dream of having a stand at the greatest show in the world, he decided to ruin it for everyone. Didn't you?
That's right. They said my idea stank, so I thought I'd get my own back.
But how?
By making a bomb!
Calm down, everyone. It's not a real bomb. He was using those eggs to create a giant stink bomb. Which would last for days, thus rendering the show inhospitable due to the foul stench.
But how did he get the eggs to go bad so quickly?
Do you recall that warehouse I sent you to?
Hey, how can I forget?
And do you remember a funny smell?
Since you mention it, there was a certain pong in the air, but I just thought it was Mrs. Hudson. On account she was sweating quite a bit.
Try abseiling down inside a burning building and see if you don't sweat a little bit.
But the building wasn't on fire, was it?
That's quite warm in there, though.
That was the heat from the manure. He had been using the warehouse as a place to produce and store his hand cream. But when he was refused a stand, he changed the use. He then took the eggs and placed them in the dung heap for a few hours and let the poop do the rest.
Oh, that is disgusting.
Disgusting but true, Mrs. H.
It doesn't matter that you found out about my plan, because it's too late!
What does he mean?
I've already triggered the bomb's mechanism!
Everybody stop! So, he set it off. Now, where could it be? I know what we need to do. Rewind! Stop! Got it. Fast forward. Stop.
It doesn't matter that you found out about my bomb. You'll never find it.
Yes, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but then again, it's my job. Yes, your hiding place was clever, but not clever enough.
But where is it, Holmes? Where is the hiding place?
Anybody? Anybody?
Umbrella.
You know what? That's a good idea, isn't it? Look! It's the umbrella in the lost umbrella stand!
Well done.
Yes, I was going to say, what?
He's right, you know. I mean, look at the weather. It's glorious. Who would bring an umbrella out in this weather?
And the show has only just started. And someone's already lost an umbrella.
So, the umbrella... is the bomb?
Not at all, Inspector. No, when he arrived, he placed the umbrella in the stand, thus puncturing a seal at the base, which now has a pipe, which, if I'm not mistaken, leads to the real bomb.
And of course, when everyone's arrived, he leaves, taking the umbrella with him,
thus releasing a pungent odour into the air.
And everyone would have fled, leaving the show empty, and then ruining it for everyone.
Oh, well, that's very sneaky.
Quite! Now, just to be clear, nobody touch it until the bomb disposal unit arrives. Apart from me. Holmes, you've not explained why go to the trouble of kidnapping the Three Sombreros.
Yes, I think Mrs. Hudson should be able to help with this.
Oh, yes?
What would stop you from watching the Three Sombreros?
Oh, absolutely nothing, Mr. Holmes. Not even my head fell off.
Okay. Thank you, Mrs. Hudson. But, you see, he couldn't be sure that people would even notice a bad smell, let alone leave.
But you've not explained how the paper boys knew everything before it happened.
Yes. I almost forgot. Hey, use this.
No, don't! That's mine!
What on earth is it?
Yes, what is it?
This is how he managed to stay one step ahead of everyone and how the paper boys knew everything that was going on.
Yes, but what is it?
It's the script, of course.
The script?
Yes, how else do you think you would have made it this far? Yes, it was very clever, but he missed out one thing.
What?
Why, the alternate ending, of course. As it happens, I'm on first-name terms with the writer, and, well, the rest is history. Or the future, so to speak.
Oh! I've won! It said so there that I've won! I'll get you, fellas, Sherlock Holmes! Curse you!
Yes, I somehow doubt that. Did I mention I went to the address on that application form?
No! You didn't!
I did! And guess who I bumped into?
Who?
Where is he?
Ah, right on cue.
Mr. Holmes, sorry I'm late. I couldn't find anywhere to park the cart.
No problem at all.
Who is she?
I recognise that tone of voice anywhere. That's his mother!
Mother?
That can't be good.
Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce you to Mrs. Ethel Dungsworth. Mrs. Dungsworth, may I introduce you to the Mayor.
Oh, your lordship. Excuse my impertinence. I didn't know I was going to be meeting such fine dignitaries as yourself.
Quite.
Mr. Holmes never conveyed that I would be all conflabbing with royalty.
No, I'm not actually royalty, although I do get to meet the Queen.
The Queen? God bless her soul. I don't think I've ever been so honoured, sir. Please convey my deepest felicitations and considerations to Her Majesty next time you convolute with her.
Indeed I will, madam. Mr. Holmes.
Yes, Mrs. Dungsworth here.
Call me Ethel.
Oh, lovely. Ethel here was quite surprised when I popped in to pay her a visit.
Oh, I told you to go before you left the house.
Oh, again, not what I meant, Mrs. H, but thank you very much. Okay. No, Ethel here was quite disturbed to learn what Morris had been up to.
Who?
Her son, Morris.
Yes, where is the little blighter?
Is this the gentleman you're looking for, madam?
There you are. What have you been up to this time?
Hello, Mum.
Don't you worry, me. Just you wait till I get you home.
But Mum, I mean,
what have you been up to this time?
Nothing, I didn't do anything.
Bothering all these people with your silly ideas and nasty smells?
It wasn't a silly idea.
Don't interrupt me when I'm speaking and just you wait till I get you home.
Oh, Mum.
And where did you get that fancy suit you're wearing?
I borrowed it.
From whom, may I ask?
Grandad!
Grandad? You borrowed it from your grandad? I thought I recognised it.
I just don't know where you get it from.
Sorry for intruding. I'm a doctor. Perhaps I could help.
Thanking you kindly for the offer, sir, but he's seen a doctor when he was younger.
Oh, which doctor?
No, just a regular doctor. Now, if you'll excuse us, I think I should be having a quiet word at home with me son.
Shouldn't we be taking him off to jail, Inspector?
Well, I should think so. What do you think?
Yes.
Jail, right, jail, yes. Well, maybe we should, Mr. Holmes, what would you recommend in these circumstances, after all, you are an expert in these matters?
Well, I think Ethel here has it under control, don't you, Ethel?
Oh.
Oh, yes, Mr. Holmes. Rest assured he won't be doing anything like this again. Straight to bed when you get in.
But, Mum, I'm 56!
Catch up me, would you?
No! I won't do it again, Mum, honestly, I won't! Oh, Mum!
One feels quite sorry for the young man under the circumstances. One's own mummikins can be quite the adversary when challenged. Sorry.
But who was he exactly?
Just plain old Morris Dunsworth. His job was shoveling manure off the streets. That was the perfect cover for stealing the eggs.
That explains a lot, though.
I have to say, I actually feel quite sorry for him, like the mayor. He'll be back at work tomorrow. Do you know how many horses there are in London? A lot. Yeah, he thought he had what was a good idea with Pew, something that would raise him above the slums. But really, no matter which way you look at it, it's all just a load of crap.
You're not wrong there.
Anyway, probably about time we opened this show, man.
I couldn't agree more, Mr. Holmes. I appear to have got my regal mare medal stuff. Gentlemen, could I be... In fact, I'm going to come and get this. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce, after a brief delay, that the Great British Show is officially open! And here, for your enjoyment, are the one and only the three sombreros.
Constantine, Sebastian, Frederike, Carlito.
And together, we are the Three Sombreros.
Wonderful, thank you very much to our esteemed guest, who will now be so kind to judge the cake competition. Let's see who the lucky winner is.
For the adventure. And hey, they don't call me Sherlock for nothing.
I just don't know how you just get all the clues and decide what's right, what's wrong, what's relevant. I just could never do it.
Well, I suppose you'd like to know, would you?
I'd love to.
And I suppose you lot would like to know, would you?
Yeah.
beat it up, and then you gotta slow it down. Cause if you believe that a plan can hit the top, you gotta play around. And soon you will find that there comes a time for making your mind up. For making your mind up. And then you gotta play it out. You gotta push it on, and it's something everybody's gonna talk about. And soon you will find that the time's right for making your mind up. Don't let your indecision take you from the high. Don't let others change your mind. But you really gotta burn it up and make it up a fire by night. Get a run for your money and take a chance, and it'll turn out right. And when you see how it's gotta be, you're making your mind up. You're making your mind up. You're making your mind up.
As you can tell, well rehearsed.
Yes. I knew most words.
You know what? We could probably do with some help, and I've just spotted all these people here. Why don't we have a little contest, shall we?
Sounds good, but how are they going to know the words?
That is an excellent question. Oh, wait, what's this?
Don't get it.
I'll tell you what, how about, and this is just off the top of my head, yes? We'll take this side,
yeah.
And we'll sing against your side, and we'll see who's best.
Obviously us. We'll be next. Stupid question. Well, I like to class myself as a gentleman. And for that reason, I say ladies first.
Okay, fine. Ron, if you wouldn't mind.
Come on.
You gotta speed it up, and then you gotta slow it down. Cause if you believe that a plan can hit the top, you gotta play around. And soon you'll find that there comes a time for making your mind up. For making your mind up. For making your mind up. For making your mind up.
I tell you what, I'm getting a little bit emotional about how good that was.
I just love how they clapped themselves. Now, I'm not even sure they joined in. Would you get them?
Go on then, show us what you've got then.
Oh, too right, come on, Clue, let's go. Hit it, Ronnie! Now!
You gotta speed it up, and then you gotta slow it down. Cause if you believe that a plan can hit the top, you gotta play around. Cause soon you will find that it comes in time for making your mind up. Play around, cause when you
show yet?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. I'll see you on the other side. See you soon.
Me, nothing that I can't be
someone by your side to sing along.